For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales First Quarter 2008 from your Sample Files folder. In this lesson, you're going to disassemble a large worksheet and make it into three smaller worksheets. You'll often find that data is easier to work with if you divide it into logically separated sections. This workbook shows all sales completed in January, February, and March 2008. Your task will be to split them into separate months. So I'll begin by creating a new worksheet named January. You learnt how to do this in Lesson 1-9. So I'll click the New Sheet button, then I'll double-click on the text Sheet 1, and I'll type January on the keyboard, and then press the Enter key. Now I'm going to copy all of the transactions from the first quarter 2008 worksheet into the new January worksheet. Eventually, I'll also delete the February and March transactions. So I'll click on the first quarter 2008 worksheet, and I need to select every cell in the worksheet. I can do this using the Select All button at the top left of the worksheet. When I've clicked the Select All button, I can right-click anywhere in the selected area and select Copy from the shortcut menu. Then I'll click on the January worksheet tab, click in cell A1, and then right-click and paste to paste all of the cells from the first quarter 2008 worksheet into the January worksheet. Now I'll create another duplicate of the first quarter 2008 worksheet using a simpler technique. I'll first right-click on the first quarter 2008 worksheet and select Move or Copy from the shortcut menu. And notice that there's a checkbox saying Create a Copy at the bottom left of the Move or Copy dialog. This is my way of telling Excel whether I want to move or copy the worksheet. So I'll check Create a Copy, and I'll also tell Excel to Move to End. That means that the duplicate worksheet will be created to the right of the January worksheet. I'll click OK, and there's my new worksheet. Now I'll double-click on First Quarter 2008-2, and I'll name this worksheet February, and press the Enter key. Now I'll create another duplicate of the First Quarter 2008 worksheet, and this final technique is the best, easiest, and fastest technique. I'll first click on the First Quarter 2008 worksheet tab to select it, then I'll hold down the Control key on the keyboard, and then I'll click and begin dragging to the right. Now notice that two things have happened. First of all, I can see an icon with a plus symbol on it. And also, I can see a small black arrow. At the moment, it's pointing to a location between the first quarter 2008 and the January worksheets. But as I continue to drag to the right, it's now moved to between January and February, and it's now moved to the right of February. So when I release the mouse button, the duplicate worksheet is created to the right of the February worksheet tab. I'll double-click now on First Quarter 2008-2, and I'll rename this worksheet March. Now I need to remove the transactions that are not appropriate for each of the January, February, and March worksheets. So I'll begin with January. I click on the January worksheet tab, and I'm going to scroll down until I can see the first February transaction. There it is, in row 87. So I'll click the row 87 row header to select row 87, and then scroll down to the end of the worksheet. Then I'll hold down the Shift key on the keyboard and click the row header for the last row. I've now selected all of the February and March rows, so I'll right-click inside the selected range and then click Delete on the shortcut menu. Now I'll do a similar thing for the February worksheet. I select the February worksheet, and I'll begin by selecting the first January transaction. That's row 2. Then I'll scroll down until I see the first February transaction. I'll hold down Shift on the keyboard and select the last January transaction. I then right-click inside the selected area and click Delete from the shortcut menu to delete the rows. Now I'll scroll down to the last February transaction and I'll select the row containing the first March transaction. So I click on the row header for row 81. Then I'll scroll to the end of the worksheet, hold down the Shift key and click the row header for row 157. I'll then right-click inside the selected range and select Delete from the shortcut menu. Now let's fix up the March worksheet. I click on the March worksheet tab. I'll begin selecting the row containing the first January transaction, that's row 2. Then I'll scroll down to the first March transaction and I'll select the row just before it. So I'll hold down Shift key on the keyboard and then click on the row header for row 165. Now I'll right-click inside the selected cells and click Delete on the shortcut menu. And I now have a worksheet with all transactions for the first quarter in the first quarter 2008 worksheet, all transactions for January in the January worksheet, all transactions for February in the February worksheet, and all transactions for March in the March worksheet. All that remains now is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name, Sales First Quarter 2008-1. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above, my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 6.3, Duplicate Worksheets Within a Workbook.